Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today I will be explaining how to use EpicBendyRig, and you can find the link right in the description. It'll be a Google Docs, and it'll be a blend file. You can just download it there. And if you want to import into your scene, all you have to do is go to File, Append, and make sure you append the collection. And so here it is. You will click on the armature, and you can go into pose mode and pose it however you would like. Just click on any bone and rotate it, move it, and then for the face you can click on a bone. This bone right here, you can go into, if you go into the properties tab under armature and go into pose library, you can click on the mouth poses or the eyes poses. Then you can click on any of these and apply them, or you can click Alt L and then just scroll through the different ones. Then for the eyebrows, you can just click on these bones and move them however you would like. And if you want the arms or the legs to be an IK or FK, all you have to do is go to the properties panel, go into the armature tab, and then go into custom properties, and you can just find the right slider and slide it to 1. And so here I'm switching the arms into FK, so you can now move this one controller instead of having to move like 3 bones. And you can rotate it to rotate the hand, and then the legs are now in FK because they're originally in IK. Then you can just rotate them like a normal FK rig. So let's undo all that, and then I will undo these. Okay, next, if we want to switch the change textures, for example, change the texture of the face here, all you would have to do is click on the plane, go into edit mode, and then switch, slide over another screen, divide the screen in half, and change this half into image editor. And so here, all you have to do is go up here and change the image, find the right image of the face. Then you can go into image, save image as, and save the image, and then you can import it into any software you want, and it will and then you can customize it however you would like. The same thing for any body part. You can click on it, and then here's the UV layout. All you have to do is go to UVs, export UV layout, and then you can draw, add another layer and draw on top of this and draw whatever texture you would like. So yeah, that's about it. And then if you want to use textures from Mecabricks, you would just have to download Mecabricks Lite or Mecabricks Advanced and import the figure, which I have one here. Then all you would have to do is switch this screen over here into shader editor, click on the body part you want, go into the shader tab in the properties panel, add a new shader, and then I will click on the Kai torso over here. Then all you have to do is go into decorations, find this image in this UV map. I will Control C, copy it, go over here to my body. I will press Control V and paste it, and then I will move it into the right position and put it into the base color. But now the background color is black, so I will press Control A, add a mesh shader, duplicate this principal BSDF, and then plug it into the top one, and then plug in the alpha into the factor of the mesh shader. And then if I want exact background color, I can go over here into base color, base material 1, go into the hex, copy this hex number, press Control C, and then I will go over here to the corresponding torso, and then go paste the hex here, and now we have the right colors. And then you can do anything, and let's say for example that this texture didn't look right. All you have to do is go in here and change the UV map So for example, this UV map is wrong. All you have to go is go into the UV map node and change to the correct UV map, and it should look good. We can do the same thing for these legs. Go into the decoration, copy this image and UV map node, press Ctrl C, go into the corresponding leg, create a new shader. I will press Ctrl V, paste. I will move it and place into the base color. I will again press Shift A and add a mix shader. Duplicate this principle in BSDF, put it into the top green one, and then put the alpha of the image into the put the alpha of this image into the factor of the mix shader, and then again you can paste the hex number in here to get the correct background color, and then just choose the right UV map. This one is wrong, as you can see the textures don't line up, so just find another UV map, and here the UV map is correct. So now it works. And let's say for example you want this hair piece to be on this figure, all you have to do is duplicate it, move it over, place it in the right position. You might have to scale it a little bit like this, and then I will go into the constraints tab in the properties panel, add a child of constraint, select the armature, find the hair bone, and click set inverse, and now we can click on the hair bone and rotate it, and the hair will move. And if you rotate on the z-axis, you can move it like this. And let's say for example that the hair bone was too small, all we'd have to do is go to the armature tab and go to the custom properties and change this accessory bone size to make sure you'll be able to see it. And the same thing goes for the child minifigure, which I have right here. If we get out of pose mode, we can click on this armature and go into pose mode. It's basically the same thing except for these legs here, which we can just move like the normal big legs. But if you want to go into FK, you can just go down here into the custom properties and change it to FK. And here we can like rotate the legs and make him look like he's setting, or rotate it like normal. So yep, that's pretty much it. Hope you enjoyed the video and hope you make some cool stuff with it, and see you next video.